sometimes you're not trying to persuade the person that people think you're trying to persuade. What you're actually doing is trying to persuade lots of other people at the same time. I've spent my whole life as an educator, as a scientific educator, at Oxford. And at Oxford we have a rather unique system, the tutorial system, where every student gets a one-hour, one-on-one tutorial each week with a tutor. And I had this as an undergraduate, which I absolutely loved. And then throughout my career, I was a tutor. So I would have student after student after student coming into my room, spending an hour with me. They would produce an essay, we would talk about it. And I would be trying to, and we would have a conversation. So I got very practiced in the art of persuading people of scientific things. I think this may show itself in my writing, the discipline of putting yourself in the shoes of the reader, of the other person, asking yourself all the time, what could be misunderstood here? In what way might my words be misconstrued? How can I get this? This person is not really getting it. I can see it from their face that they're puzzled. Maybe an analogy would help. Maybe a metaphor would help. So I suppose the only general thing I can think is put yourself in the position of your audience. Try to see where they're coming from, sympathetically, and argue your case in a way that should resonate with them. There is a difference between persuading a single individual, which is what I was talking about in the case of an Oxford tutorial, and persuading a whole audience who are, say, reading a book or listening to perhaps a radio program, where, I mean, sometimes I've done, quite frequently in America, I've done shows where there's a phone in and people phone in and ask me questions or have an argument with me. And there I have sometimes given up, I have to confess this, I've sometimes given up on the quest to persuade the person who is arguing with me. I might regard them as a lost cause, but I'm conscious of the fact that thousands of other people are listening in. And the way I handle my argument with the one person, who may be, say, a young earth creationist who's beyond redemption, clearly isn't going to believe anything I say. Nevertheless, by the method that I argue with them may be a total failure as far as persuading them is concerned, but nevertheless may persuade thousands of other people who are listening in.